Hello friends, today I'm going to talk about how to set up SQL replication using asnclp command line between two different instances. Last time when I recorded this particular SQL replication video, what I did is I ran the capture and apply in the same database under the same instance. What exactly was done is the source table and target table was in the same database. You will never do this in real-time production scenario. So we will normally replicate between two different instances or two different databases. So that's what was the. So this particular video is more to do on a production-like scenario where we have two different instances. Although my instances are in the same server, but the concept remains same. So this is what I'm going to do. So I got Db2 version 10.5.5, fixed pack 5. Instances Db2P and Db2S, these are the two instances. I got a database called DBSRC and I got another database called DBTGT. In DBSRC, I got two tables called staff and employee. So under DBSRC, I got these two tables. My end result is to replicate these two tables from DBSRC to DBTGT under db2s instance. So from this particular db src, which is under db2p, will be replicated to db tgt, which is under db2s. We have lots of steps to do this. So to do this, we will be cataloging the db src in db2s. So we have lot of steps to cover. So what I will do is I will start with creation of the databases, because to create the database is going to take some time. So I'll set up this particular script. One of the requirement is the source database where capture is running. That database needs to be under the archival logging. It should not be in circular logging because the logs needs to be captured. So under db2s, I'm creating this particular database called dbtgt, and under dbsrc, I'm creating under db2p, I'm creating a database called dbsrc. So I have ran this particular script. So existing database will be dropped, and here also existing database. So dbsrc under db2p and dbtgt under db2s. So I'm doing this. While it's doing that, what I'll explain you is what are the steps. So the steps would be, we need to under db2s, that we will catalog this particular database. So from db2s, we should be able to access this database, and from db2p, we will access this particular database. Capture will be running on db2p and apply will be running on db2s. So this is my capture. So the source database is under db2p, hence capture will run here, apply will run here. So what we'll do, create control tables for capture, then we'll create control tables for apply, then we'll create the subscription sets, then we will register the source, and then we'll create the member. Once all of these are done, we'll run the capture and apply. This time around, I have broken down this as one script, this as another script, and this as another script. So this, because I have two tables, I have broken down this into two different scripts. So let me show you while this is running. Let me show you. Okay, so the database is still getting created. So let me go to my home under ASN. Okay, so what I'm going to show you, this is the script. So here what I'm saying is, for DBSRC, this is my capture server, this is my control. So control is where apply is running. So this, the under DBSRC, my capture is running and my apply is running under DBTGT, which is also my target. So my capture is DBSRC, or this is where my source will be there. And control is where apply is running, and I'm running apply on the db2s or the on the dbtgt. And I'm saying set run script now, and I'm going to create control tables for capture server and create control tables for apply. So actually, while that is being done, okay, so let's see if the database has been created. No, not yet. Okay, so this is CentOS. For some reason, the database creation takes a little bit of time. Give it a minute. I think I should be fine. So let me see what it is doing actually. So let me open another window and run db2diag.-f. Okay, so dbsrc not activated, so it's doing something. Give it a minute. While it's doing this, let me Okay, so the databases are getting still created. Okay, while this is getting created, so what I'll show you is this is, so first I'm first script asnclp01, I'm going to create the control tables for capture server and control tables for apply. The control tables for capture will be created in dbsrc because I have set server capture to dbsrc, and my apply tables will be created in dbtgt. Once this is done, the second script is, this particular script only creates the subsystem set. So I will be creating this particular subsystem set, and this particular subsystem set will be created in dbtgt. Okay, so we'll create this subsystem set. Now once that has been done, I am going to register table called staff, and this particular table from dbsrc I will replicate to db, again same name, I'm using the same name under dbtgt. So first I'll register the table, registration will happen on the this one, and the set, the subsystem set will be created in the target. So we will create the subsystem set in the target, while the capture, the registration of the source will happen in dbsrc. Same thing I have done for the employee. So again I'm using the same name, so the table name will be similar in both the databases, that dbsrc and dbtgt. Let's see if the database is okay. So database is created. Okay, so now that database is created, let me clear the screen. Okay, so I have one database here. Okay, so let me actually activate this particular database, and here I will activate this particular database. Now I'll just show you my list db. So I got one database called dbsrc here, and list db I got one database called dbtgt here. So I got this particular databases, and what are the databases which are active? Okay, I have got dbtgt active here and dbsrc active here. Now what I'll do is I'll go to replication center. The replication center I'm not going to use to show, to configure anything. I'm just going to use replication center to show you the steps that I'm doing. So my definition, so capture control server, I'm saying add dbsrc under instance db2p. I'm adding this particular server using this particular id. Next, finish. Now it says that insufficient control tables. That looks like this particular database does not have the control tables. The reason being, we did not run the first script, which is to create the capture control table. So this particular thing has not yet been done, and hence this particular is saying insufficient control tables in dbsrc. So similarly, what we will do, okay, so it's not adding at all. So let's, okay, so it has not added. See, nothing has added. So let me try to add the apply, which is dbtgt. Okay, insufficient control tables. Again, dbtgt is also not getting added because we have not created the apply control tables. So I'm not going to use replication center to do that. I'm going to do it using this particular script. So let me run this particular script on my, so let me, okay, so now that, okay, so what I need to do is I need to catalog, because when I am going to run this, okay, so when I'm going to run this particular script, the capture control tables will be created in dbsrc and apply will be created in dbtgt, which means if I had to run this particular script, I need to be able to connect to dbtgt from the instance where I'm running this particular script, and that's why I need to catalog the dbtgt, this particular database, under instance db2p. So let me try to catalog this particular database. That's done. So now I got two databases here. One is the local database dbsrc, and one is my target database. So dbtgt is my target database, which is the from db2s, from this particular instance, this particular database, and from this particular database dbsrc is the local database. Similarly, I'll do this because I need to, when I run the apply on target, I need to be able to connect to Db2P, the DB source database, which means I need to have this particular database DBSRC on my second instance. So let me go to that particular instance. Here, right now it has got only one database, which is DBTGT. I will catalog DBSRC here, and now I got DBSRC, which is remote database, and DBTGT, which is the local database on DB2S. Now I have what I have done. So on DB2S, I have cataloged DBSRC. On DB2P, I have cataloged DBTGT. So that's been done. So now let me try to run this particular script on my first this one. So before doing while creating the tables, I don't need to have the tables created, so let me not do that. So what I'll do is I'll go to here and I'll just run this particular script. Okay, so I'm on db2p, and what I'm doing, okay, I'm running this particular script. What this particular script is doing, so I'll just show you again, is this particular script is just creating the control tables. So control tables for capture and control tables for apply. So let me run this particular script. Okay. So now it is creating all of these control tables in the capture, which is DBSRC, and apply control tables in DBTGT. So it's going to do this. And once it is done this, then we can add these two databases here. Right now, we were not able to add. Okay, so DBTGT, we were able to add. Now, we will try to add our DBSRC. Okay, you see, previously, I was not able to add the DBSRC and DBTGT, but now I'm able to add this database. And right now, registered tables or subscription set is literally empty. So I don't have any subscription set, neither I have any registered tables. The reason of this is because the reason why I don't have the subscription set, because all that I did is I just created the control capture control tables for DBSRC and apply control tables for DBTGT. When I did that, I was able to catalog this particular database under my replication center. I have launched using my Windows. Okay, this is on Windows. And everything I'm doing under the Linux, which is CentOS box. Once this has been done, so now my everything seems to be zero success, zero errors, zero warning. So everything seems to be completed successfully. Now that this has been done, what I'll do is I will try to select. Okay, so first I need to actually create the tables. So what I'll do is I will create these tables. So before creating the tables, I'll just show you what is that script. So I'm creating a table called staff and employee, and I'm adding only one record under staff. So staff 110 HR, so this is a department. And employee 210 Subo, so this is employee. So I'm adding these particular two tables, and let me run this particular script, and I'm creating these particular tables under DBSRC. So I'm creating this particular table under DBSRC. So that's been done. So now if I run the select from, so there is one script called select. So let me show you that also. Let me remove all of this. So let me just run this select query. Okay, so what it does, okay, no, I did not run the select. So I'm selecting DBSRC, I'm selecting the records from this. In this particular table, that is one record. In this particular table, that is one record. Here, this is a target database, and I'm trying to select from these tables, and it will say that these two tables does not exist because we just created these tables on the source. So let me run this particular script. See, db2 p staff and db2 employee is not present on target, while on source these particular two tables are there. These two tables are not present under the dbtgt at, because we just created these two tables in dbsrc. Then my next step would be to create a subscription set. So right now you see under dbtgt there is no subscription set is there, so it's literally empty. My next step is to create a subscription set. To create a subscription set, I'm saying create subscription set. I'm giving the set name, giving the apply qualifier. I'm saying activate interval 1, start date. I'm giving this particular start date and time. So this particular command will create in subscription set. So right now there is no subscription set. So let me run this particular script. Okay, so that's been done. Now if I refresh this, I should be able to see a subscription set, exactly what I specified here. My subscription set, so what I specified was, set 00 aq 00. So set 00 aq 00. So that's my, so this is the name of the, and this is the apply qualifier. So I have created this particular subscription set. Once that has been done, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add. So right now, till now, if I do select, I see these two tables are missing. Staff is missing, employee is missing. What I will do now is I will register. So I will register this particular source, and then I'll create this particular members, this particular table in target. So this particular table automatically will get created in dbtgt. This particular table will get created automatically, so I don't have to manually create it. So asnclp does it for me. So let me, but the data will not come. The data will only come when we start the capture and apply. All it will do is like it will create the structure for this particular table. So let's do that. And right now you see I don't have any registered tables, neither dependent targets. So let's run the third script. So I am saying create registration for staff, and then basically I'm saying create member. So once this has been done, if I refresh my dependent targets now, you see staff is my dependent target, and if I say registered tables, so staff is registered, which is under staff CD. So this particular table has been registered. So right, so what we did, we just created this particular table. Now if I run the select query again, you should be able to see, previously when I ran the select query, you was able to see that we were not having this particular staff table under dbtgt. Now if I run the select query again, you should be able to see the staff table is there, but there is no record. In staff table, I got one record here under DBSRC, but here there is no record under DBSRC. So the reason, sorry, under DBTGT, under staff record, the table got created. How the table got created is by use, when I created this member auto in the particular, this particular set, automatically the structure of this table got replicated in DBTGT under this particular apply target database. This particular table got created, but no record is still transmitted because we have not run the capture and apply. Now what I'll do is so right now I have registered only one, so which is the staff table. Okay, so target is this, so staff table is my so the target name is staff and source name is also staff. So the name, I kept the name of the same, stable same. So under the source, the table name is also staff, and under the target, the table name is also staff. I'll register one more table called employee. When I register one more table called employee, so what I'll do, I'll use this particular fourth script, and I'm going to register this particular table, and I'm going to create the member in this particular set. Now when I do that, okay, so right now you see this particular script shows employee is not there. So this particular script shows employee is not there. So I'll run the fourth script to register my fourth table. So I'm going to register it. And then when I do the select again, you see I got under dbtgt, I got staff as well as I got the employee table. Again, no records are there, but on the source there is one record in each table. My next, so right now everything is set up. So let me show you again my replication center. So here now two registered tables. I have registered staff and employee. Here I have registered only one subscription set. I have registered two tables, employee and staff. Staff is getting replicated to staff. Employee is getting replicated to employee. So that's what has been done. And what we have not done as of now is we have not replicated. So right now, if I run the select again, under DBTGT, there is no record at all. Under DBTGT, there is no record at all. But under DBSRC, there is one record. So my next step would be to run the capture on DB2P and apply on DBTGT. So let me do that. And to do that, what I'm doing is I'm running this particular under, I'll start apply first and I'll start capture later. So under db2s I'm running the apply, under db2p I'm running the capture. So let me run this particular part. Okay, so if I show you jobs here, my capture is running. So now if I run ps minus ef grep asn, you should be able to see. Okay, let me clear this. And okay, so you should be able to see I got my apply running under db2s, my capture running under db2p, which means my capture is running under instance db2p and my apply is running under db2s. Apply is where my target database is there. Capture is where my source database is there. So this capture is running under source db2p and apply is running under db2s. Now that I have started capture and apply, let's see the data whether that got replicated. You see, now I got one record here, which is 110 HR in DBSRC, and that one record has come here in 110 HR. So that particular record in DBTGT has got replicated. Similarly, 210 Subodh in my employee table got replicated. Till now, here it was 00. How this particular record got replicated is because we started capture and apply. So since we started the capture and apply, these two records got. So now what I'll do is, now that capture and apply is running, I have got one more script to insert the data, which I will show you. So this particular script is pretty simple. So this particular script connects to source and it inserts two records in staff table, 120 and 130. So staff is 120 and department is finance, and 130 department is this one. And another two records, 220 in Mahesh, 220 employee, 230 Ravindra. So this particular two records are getting added in employee table, two records. And if I do the select, there is only one record. So on source there is one record, on target there is one record. Now I'm going to use this insert to insert only in DBSRC. Once this particular two records are inserted in staff and under this particular target, I'll run this select query again, and over the time, few seconds it will take to replicate these particular records, these two records that we have inserted under DBSRC and these two records under employee in DBSRC, they will get replicated to this. So let's get started. So what, now that my capture and my apply is running, so apply is also running and capture is also running, let me try to insert the records. Now that my insert has completed, let me do the select. Okay, so here I got three records, here I got three records, and here I got only one record. So literally I do not have this particular records, these two extra records that I have inserted, still now they are not replicated under DBTGT. So let me run this select again. So still now it's not replicated. What I will do is I will sleep for 20 seconds. After running the select, I'm going to run the select thrice. and every time I run the select, I'm going to sleep for 20 seconds. So what I've done here, I ran this particular. So let me run the select every 20 seconds. So, okay. So till now, there are three records here and only one record each. Now it's sleeping for 20 seconds. Let's give it 20 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Still now it is not. First 20 seconds are done. So now again 20 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4. My seconds may not be accurate. So I'm just trying to spend some time here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, I'm pretty good. Okay. So and this is the last select. Okay. So last select, you see, it seems to have the records have got replicated. So here under DBTGT till now, under DBTGT you had only two records, 110. So under DBTGT only two records, and now if I come here, DBSRC had three records and DBTGT. Okay, it's not okay. So that's where the replication has happened, which means that whatever records I insert now, till my capture and apply is running, till these programs are running, whatever records get inserted in my DBSRC, under my DBSRC, under staff table, that will get replicated. So from this particular table, employee source table, they will get replicated to this particular employee table under DBTGT from DBSRC, and from this particular table, it will get replicated to this particular table. So we have this. I just showed you replication center. I did not use this replication center to do anything, but I just wanted to show you how my mapping looks, what you can do. So this particular replication center is still there. You can use it under 10.5. I'm using 10.5, and this is I'm not sure whether it will show you here. Yeah, it's version 10.5. So you see, this particular replication center is available in 10.5. So I'm using that particular replication center, and replication center, actually I'm not using it to do anything. I'm not using it to create replication or set up replication. I just use it to show it to you how it looks. So again, I'll just have to repeat. I'll repeat the steps. So we need to catalog this particular table DB database under this particular instance. So I've done the cross catalog. What I can actually tell you is, now that we have cataloged this particular database under db2p, we no longer need it. If I need to run asnclp, so I can just uncatalog this database from my db2p, because the capture does not connect to the apply. It is apply which connects to the capture. So I don't need this particular entry anymore. But if you want to run asnclp commands, you need this particular entry. The steps were, to first I created the control tables, then I created the for capture, then for apply, then I created a set, then I created this registration, and then I added the member. Once that has been done, I ran the capture on the source instance, and I ran the apply on the target instance. Before ending this particular session, I would like to show you all of my scripts so that you know what I have used. So this is my first script. So here I'm creating the control tables for capture and creating the control tables for apply. This particular part remains same for all my asnclp scripts. So this particular part remains same. This is my first script where I'm creating the capture control tables and apply control table. Once that has been done, I'm saying I'm creating a subscription set. Again, this particular part remains the same. Once I've created the subscription set, I registered one table called staff, and that particular table I'm adding under the member. So I'm creating this particular member under the under set 00. Again, I have, once this has been done, I have added one more table called employee. So what I have done is, like, I have added two tables called staff and employee. Once all of my tables are so first is capture control table, apply control table, then the subscription set, then registration of the table and the member in the subscription set for staff, again same thing for employee. Once all of this has been done, what I've done is I have ran this particular apply on target at capture on source. So on source instance db2p, I ran the capture, and on target I ran the apply. I hope this particular tutorial was useful. Do pass in your comments. Thanks for watching and see you in next tutorial. Bye bye.